The pistol, where in the dark spots by taking himself to fight for a few kills. Rucker missing some bullets, and his Kresno and Boris pushing into the side. Monta able to take it over. We'll have the 4v3 to play with. Retake needs to come in. BTN comes out from short, trying to tap it away. Will eventually be the 1-2 fall down, and just like that, all the kills are coming in, and the 2v2 will be found. War 2K final player remaining. He's getting tapped away, and Ursin picks himself up the third kill to pick Nexus up the first round. Click, they managed to qualify for the RMR, of course. That's something you cannot really do whenever you're not a very good and structured team. They've made a lot of good things from it. Now we'll have to show it off versus the teams of the likes of Nexus. BTN will pick himself up. That one kill is going to be traded out, and a 3v3 has been found. Xello coming out from CT. Great shots from him. Gets damaged down by the scout himself. Trade coming in. Another one is found by Cement, and now it's all in the hands of War2K.
He will make some noise. Transitions over to that Galil, spots out Xello, tags him down, but he will get them in.
And then potentially tie things up. BTN close, takes down Kresnel, pushed into a new underpass. That's a good entry found, and Boros.
Boros, through enemy lines, gets the first. Erison. Still hiding away. Erison dropping off whenever he does. And right now, he just trained on Ragger. In the meantime, everything is towards the A bomb site. Seminite will fall. Xello will trade him. And now Boris has a clear gateway over towards A. And he will almost take down Erison. He almost just ended up killing everyone. They know Xello isn't towards Rampant somewhere. Like, Monte are aware of this. And now that awareness will be confirmed. You did just have Warrior dancing around, drop the smoke on his body, and it will be Fessor to eliminate the last two.
Super. Phew, barely made it.
Oh, no!
Freeze! There's no escape!
Damn it, no ammo.
Stay there, I say! Surrender! This time, luck isn't on your side!
Let's check it out.
Shit!
What the hell is that?
Oh crap!
You missed, motherfucker!
What the fuck is going on?
Wow, this must be my lucky day. The link is in the description box.
To work with on middle, no AWP out for either side. And oh god, look at this, quickly Boros. Quickly blinded, but Thessal will be there to salvage that kill. You can see Seminite as well, trying to make something work over towards ladder. That nade from Boros will do quite a bit of damage. Not as much as I would have anticipated, actually. And in the meantime, BTN will strike, replaces his fallen comrade in connector, does get the reload off, and can't get the kill off. Back to a 3v3. Waro still lurking in middle, will catch Seminite off guard, and trades so fast, so furious. And look at where Kras now is. He's stuck between the two of them, and on the full, Ragger still somehow kills him.
Just managed to find it up, but it was a Molly instead. Waro hears them both running, gets cleared, but then finds himself the first, doesn't find the second, and his Nexus having a reaction to it and finding around back. No, not quite. Rucker just keeps on jumping, but Kresnel's already in comfortable position. Boros on the A side, able to find a double, and this is Boros style.
Oh, Boros even gets another one over in CT, deep towards Market. Xello trying to rotate, trying to save his teammates. Shall get knocked down, and Thessor, the fact he has the bomb there, absolutely terrifies me. Didn't even notice.
But watching for him, then Q over the top. Samantha still coming out huge with one more, but it will be the fourth
as well, not too far off. Those are very potent, and you've got this. So you've got all that pressure over towards the A bomb site, and then you look over a middle, and you've got someone like Warren 2K holding down the fort there. In retaliation of that, Nexus will get two kills, but they still are on a man deficit now. Make that two. Krasnow, the ex Lost Recruiters, ex AGO, Jesus, man, that was. And cool. Nexus, they need to get rounds, not damage. Also, BTN, what an ratty angle that is. What a one-way smoke. I thought that was a miss smoke. That is
a... again walking up short. He's not giving a damn. Will be seen. Gonna get shut down. Nice shot there for BTN. That's already a double man. They still have to pick up this round first, and that isn't even 100% confirmed. Look at that shot from DemQ. Nice kill there on the cement. Again. Three players protecting the A site still for Nexus.
Yeah, still be careful. Those three players look like it will be good enough, and then might go back over towards the B bomb site through window here, because DemQ, okay, someone we maybe haven't highlighted too much this game, is here, and he's here to play. The AWPer at long range, he's going to duel, and he actually wins the fight. Hold on a second. 20 seconds left, and they've spotted Dragon. They know he's at the back of the bomb site. DemQ, no, you cannot be serious. The Ukrainian, four kills so far. By winning out majority of game... in battles, and right here, nice flashbang. Oh, okay, this is something. This is good. Erison has got to
flashbang an easy play. It didn't cost them a lot of utility to do so. Cementa tried to go a little bit aggressive, will eventually fall down to Kresno, who finds himself a double. Okay. This man is on a lot of level, and so is everybody here from
Wind. Up with Kresno. That will be Demi, Ukrainian, and it's Kresno. Oh, man, this is not fair. He's doing so well, but we'll overextend a wee bit, and Xello will put it back to it. Clear the angle. Ooh. He's got his flash out. Xello misses the shot. Vessel comes off the bomb, but it doesn't matter, because Ragga, he's got an AWP of his own, and he's in a 1v2, spots the head of the Dane, and nails him.
MQ, 1v1, our battle coming. But AK knows where Rocker is approximately. He's inside the top of the smoke. Now trying to stick it. 3 second defuse. Oh no, DemQ. He's not gonna completely spray it. And it will be Nexus picking up one more round. Still, well played in that type of moment. Monte lost out on the round. And Nexus is still alive.
I mean, I think if we're going to talk about that last round, the fact it was a 3v5, and then Monte almost won it out, and now here again, Monte are doing their specialty, run out A, and just aim everyone down. Boros could have to do all of it. It's a 2v2. How are Nexus keep on relieving themselves of these advantages, and Ragga in towards jungle is all by himself. He will be clearing out the A bomb site, and he is going to actually take down DemQ. Has information
run is going to be hurt, and all this is so unfortunate. Once more, Nexus winning rounds, they're staying alive, but as we mentioned,
this could be huge. Ragga's leading the charge. He will not be spotted. And ooh, okay for a second, Kresno only gets one, and it's also Boros on the back of the B bomb site, equally is felled, and Nexus now looking like they want to get their 7th round. This would be absolutely monumental for them, very important for their success in the later stages of this game. And it looks like it's going to be falling that way. 2v4, walking out of this choke point. Warrior's only going to be able to get one, and that will be all she
missing the jump on short. It's going to just be stuck in window, and DemQ, well, that's a good first pick onto Semonite.
Looking to garner those first double digits, looking to force the first gun round in their favor. Warrior just scouting out middle, might get contact very soon. And yes, he will. BTM, the IGL, falls behind boxes. And Ragga...
three mollies to push him out of his position. And that molly will already do it. Kresno just stands up and doing a lot of damage on the second. Boros able to find himself the trait. And will even find himself a double. The double digits.
And I love this. Doubling abs. Boros does get spotted, but they don't expect Waro. Bye-bye, Semonite. That's an early advantage for the internet.
To be the right call, but they have to be careful about Boros still being on short. They're not going to be able to find that frag, but they will take down Kresno. It's given a window of opportunities to move into the window. Professor is there, already waiting for him and achieving him with open arms. One more for Boros, and Nexus in shambles.
Still, there's a potentiality. I was going to say, it all comes kind of down to this, right? Depends what Erison can do out of A. He does secure the first onto the Dame. That'll be all he finds. And now Xello, they know where he is. And he has got one kill to DemQ. The remaining is his number. Jumping up on ticket. Unscoped for now. Nice quick scope. And that's easy for the Ukrainian. Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Case in my opinion. Still, not something that you might see always happen. Cement has already pushed out. Great entry for him. Trades are coming in, and Monte still has the advantage, but the B side is kind of taken under control. Bomb still yet to cross. Xello with the kill. Waro missed. That's given a window of opportunity to get that bomb.
It's coming from apartments, and one coming from CT. DemQ will lose his life to Semonite, and now Nexus from a 3v4 to a 3v2. Does get one on the outbreak, but it shall be the AWPer.
Every team. Well, so the AWPer. Now against Monte, they're showing us that Boros missing the jump. Xello finds himself the first kill, got boosted in ramp, but that's Fessor bye-bye.
What is this A bomb site right now? 3 Phallus, 1 ramp, and what a shot from DemQ. This MP9 does sing true, but it is only good for that first, and it will be it will be the ramp play of BTN just to
silence them. And it's a very strange round from Monte, because you can see that then enough to push him away. And you've got Boros in Palace, who's just died to Xalo. That's annoying.
Moro has to save. That's going to mean three plays for Nexus.
Boss called, and oh, this could look Moro finding kill, but he's actually going to tag him. That is so unfortunate.
They're now looking into a dire situation. Fesser seeing them coming from underpass. A nice double to start off the round, and this is the one they were looking for. Pushing up fast and making kills that you would like to see more and more
play with.
Ooh, that advantage has been swept away. Erison, lovely little headshot there. Being focused on by Xello. And oh, that is devastating for the pole. There's no way you'd ever expect.
We know that he can do this. One man, it could be Waro, but Erison finds the frag, spots out the head, a chance to take Cementa down. Really close to happening, and the kill comes in. He's trying to instantly fall back and gets up into the ladder room.
You can see this is the idea that Nexus, they were trying to do this in the previous rounds. And now BTN, the IGL, when he's called upon, will be there alongside Ragga. Absolutely in this potential penultimate round. And with Crass now dying there, DemQ will have the only saved weapon.
Will they make it happen, DemQ? Hiding himself on the side, Ursin is going to find the first. That's a crazy one. He showed up for a millisecond, but it was enough for him to fire and find the shot. The bomb could be delivered onto the side. It's still 1 second remaining. They're trying to take CT. Good flashbang coming in. Fesser playing anti-flash. Well done there to take down Rocket in the end. Xello is the one to fall down, and Monte fights their way back into the round. Boros keeps on going. All of a sudden, it's all left into Ursin's hands. He's not able to find it. And it's 13 on the board.
He has been multiple times, right? Usually in the left corner from the CT's perspective, but this time in the right one, Waro been able to see him, and Kresna was the one already in the end. They're walking their way into window. Boros is going to get taken down. Great shot there for Cementa. Tries to double down, but Fessar has a reaction.
Molotov goes out. Flash goes out. Kresna in towards Jail just gets absolutely obliterated. Lovely first bullet headshot from BTN. And the first point of damage is on Xello, and he barely survives, but BTN is there. The Molotov does force Xello to the left. It has to be Fessor.
Has to come in. Ursin positioning himself quite well. Fessor swings out. Will be the one to find the frag. They know where Xello is. They have him isolated. But the time is starting to tick. And Waro has to stick it. Xello finds the kill. Waro goes for the full 5 second defuse. And it's the kill that comes in. And Nexus become victorious out of this game. Impressive stuff.